The calculus was stolen from India. I think that is very important. It was stolen from India and later declared to have been discovered by Newton and Leibniz. So if we understand this process of theft and then claiming a discovery, then it tells us a very important thing, that the West may have got the stolen calculus wrong. This is, I mean, the way it got the size of the earth wrong. But colonial education declared that wrong calculus as superior. And that is the calculus we teach today. And this is what effectively I am campaigning about. But it is hard for people to understand. This is much easier. So the calculus we are teaching today may be an inferior version of the calculus we originally developed. For we never compared the two. You know of any comparison? And we almost cannot compare the two today, because our education makes it impossible for us to compare. First, the calculus is not taught properly. Just now I was talking to some lady. Have you studied real numbers? No. Have you studied real numbers? Have you studied set theory? No. So, it is not taught properly. We teach about real numbers in our school texts, but they are taught belief. They are taught faith in real numbers, not knowledge of real numbers, of formal real numbers. Even all those fat calculus texts, they don't teach knowledge of real numbers. And if a person doesn't have knowledge, what can he do? He is forced to guess. And he is forced to rely on authority. And we are taught that Western certification is the ultimate test of validity. So in any case, people are not able to apply their mind because they don't have the knowledge and they look for certificates. And we forgot the calculus that we originally had. Nobody knows about it. They don't even know whether it was calculus. So that, I think, is a major problem. It's a major problem of education, because our education in mathematics and science is centrally dependent on that.